हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज प्रियंका। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व ए प्रॉब्लम ऑन डायनेमिक्स ऑफ फ्लूइड फ्लो। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट व्हाट इज द फोर्स एक्सर्टेड बाय वाटर ऑन द पाइप बेंड। सो फर्स्ट आई विल रीड व्हाट इज द गिवन प्रॉब्लम। ए 45 डिग्री रिड्यूसिंग बेंड इज कनेक्टेड इन ए पाइपलाइन, the diameters at the inlet and outlet of the bend being 600 mm and 300 mm respectively. Find the force exerted by water on the bend if the intensity of pressure at inlet to bend is 8.829 Newton per centimeter square and the rate of flow of water is 600 liters per second. So this was the given question. We will first understand the diagram as per the given data. Now at inlet, diameter of pipe is given, that is 600 mm, and pressure intensity is also given. We will say P1 8.829 Newton per centimeter square. So at inlet we will consider here as a section 1. So this is the section 1 along this inlet. Now here the angle of bend is given, that is 45 degree. So here is the horizontal center line at the inlet, and at this point we will consider here theta is equal to 45 degree, and at this 45 degree line we will extend here this center line. Now here is the bend that we have to show. Now here is the outlet, that is along this 45 degree inclined line, and whose diameter is D2 is equal to 300 millimeter. So at outlet we will consider here as a section 2-2. So this is the diagram as per the given data. Now we have to calculate what is the force exerted by water that is flowing through this pipe on the bend. So at bend we will draw here the component of force. So what is the component of force? Because this bend is inclined, so here force is also in the inclined direction. So we will draw here component of this force along the direction of x and along the direction of y. So with the help of red marker I will draw here. So this is the vertical force component, that is Fy, and this is the horizontal force component, that is Fx. So these are the components of force that is exerted by water on this bend. Now we will calculate what is the pressure intensity at this section 2-2, that is at outlet. So for that we will first find out what is the area of this pipe at inlet and outlet. So we can easily calculate from this diameter because the diameter is given. So this diameter we have to write in the standard unit. So what is the standard unit? That is meter. So D1 is equal to 0.6 meter and D2 is equal to 0.3 meter. So what is the area? So area A1 is equal to pi by 4 D1 square, that is pi by 4 0.6 square, which is equal to 0.2827 meter square. In the same way, what is area A2, that is at section 2, that is pi by 4 D2 square, that is pi by 4 into 0.3 square, which is equal to 0.07068 meter square. Now here rate of flow is also given, that is Q. Q is equal to 600 liter per second. So this liter per second we have to convert it into meter cube per second, because meter cube per second is the standard unit. So how to convert it? So for liter per second we have to multiply with 10 raised to minus 3. So this 600 into 10 raised to minus 3, that is 0.6 meter cube per second. So this is the rate of flow. Now we will consider here this steady rate of flow. That means this Q 600 liter per second, that will remain constant along this pipe, that is at inlet also and at outlet, that is at section 2-2 also, this Q is equal to 600 liter per second. So when flow is steady we can apply here the Bernoulli's equation, or we can apply here the continuity equation. Now if we observe here A1 and A2 we have calculated, P1 is given. Now we have to find out P2. So before that we have to find out what is the velocity at section 1 and at section 2. That is V1 is equal to and V2 is equal to. So V1 is equal to and V2 is equal to, that we have to find out. So for that we can apply here continuity equation at section 1 and at section 2. So we know that Q is equal to A1 V1 which is equal to A2 V2. So this is the continuity equation when this flow is steady. So A1 and A2 is known, then Q is also known. So we can calculate here V1 and V2. So here Q is equal to A1 V1, then V1 is equal to Q by A1. So Q, this is the standard unit, we have to take 0.6 divided by A1. So this is in meter square unit we have to take. So what is V1? That is 2.122 meter per second. So this is the calculated value. In the same way, V2 is equal to Q by A2, that is 0.6 divided by 0.07068, that is 8.488 meter per second. So in this way V1 and V2 is getting calculated. Now we can apply Bernoulli's equation at section 1 and section 2. So when flow is steady we can apply here the Bernoulli's equation. So we know that what is the Bernoulli's equation, that is pressure head plus kinetic head plus datum head at section 1 which is equal to at section 2. So what is the pressure head, that is P1 by rho g plus kinetic head V1 square by 2g plus datum head Z1 is equal to. So in the same way we have to write P2 by rho g plus V2 square by 2g plus Z2. Now what is the Z1 and Z2, that is the datum head at this section 1 and section 2. So suppose we will consider the pipeline is horizontal and along that horizontal line the bend is connected. Then what is happening here, that is the bend is also having the same distance from that horizontal surface. That means we can say here Z1 is equal to Z2. So when we apply Bernoulli's equation, this Z1 is equal to Z2, that is getting cancelled from the both sides. So what is the Bernoulli's equation that remains? That is P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2g is equal to P2 by rho g plus V2 square by 2g. So now we will put the values. So what is P1? So P1 is given, that is in Newton per centimeter square. So what is the standard unit? That is Newton per meter square. So we will write here 8.829 into 10 raised to 4 Newton per meter square. So we have to use that value divided by rho g. So what is the density of water? That is 1000 into g means 9.81 plus V1 square. So what is V1? That is 2.122 square by 2 into 9.81 which is equal to, now P2 by rho g. So intensity of pressure at this section 2 that we have to calculate. So we will take here P2 by rho g as it is plus V2 square by 2g. So V2 is 8.488. square divided by 2 into 9.81. So what is the value of P2 by rho g? So when we solve this we will get P2 by rho g is equal to 5.5575 meter of water. So this is the pressure head at this section 2. So now we have to find out what is the intensity of pressure. So we will shift here this rho g to the right hand side. So here this 5.5575 multiplied by rho, that is 1000 into g, that is 9.81. So what is the value of P2? That is 5.45 into 10 raised to 4 Newton per meter square. Now we will draw free body diagram along section 1-1 and along section 2-2. So we will first take the pressure force. So we know that pressure force always acts in perpendicular direction of the surface and towards the surface, and this is according to Pascal's law. So here we will take here the section 1-1, that is the vertical surface. So we have to show this pressure force P1 A1 in perpendicular direction and towards this vertical surface, that is this is the horizontal line. In the same way we have to show the velocity. So velocity at section 1-1, that is V1, we have to show. So I will show here velocity is V1, that is also in horizontal direction, that is along the direction of x. Now we will move for the section 2. So for section 2 again we have to show what is the pressure force P to A2. So again here is the inclined surface, so this section 2 is inclined because here this center line is inclined at an angle 45 degree to the horizontal. So we have to show pressure force P2 A2 in perpendicular direction to this inclined surface, and direction is towards the surface. So here with this vertical inclined surface 2 2 we have to show the pressure force. So I will show here, that is P2 A2. So here we have to show P2 A2. Now what about the velocity? So velocity is V2, but it is, we have to show along the flow. So flow is in this direction, that is along the pipe. Here I will show, this is the direction of flow. So in the outward direction we have to show velocity. So I will show here along the center line, here is the velocity V2. Now for the free body diagram we have to resolve these forces. Now if we observe pressure force and velocity at section 1 is along the direction of x, that is both are horizontal, so P1, A1 and V1, so we will take it as it is. Now what about this P2, A2? Because this P2, A2 is in inclined direction, so we will resolve this into two components, that is horizontal component and vertical component. So I will draw here, here is the horizontal component and this is the vertical component. So now we have to find out what is the value. So first we will find out what is the angle theta. So if we observe, this is the horizontal line, so this is also horizontal line, that means these two lines are parallel to each other and this is the common inclined line in between them. So here angle theta is equal to 45 degree. So now it is easy for us to find out what is the value for this horizontal component, that is P2 A2 cos theta. So I will write here P2 A2 cos of theta. And what is the value for this vertical component, that is P2 A2 sin of theta. Now in the same way we will resolve this velocity V2. So again we have to draw here horizontal component and here is the vertical component. So again we have to find out the value of this component. So if we observe, this is the inclined line and along this inclined center line, here is with this horizontal line angle is theta. So again this is also horizontal component, so here is also 45 degree. So what is its value? That is V2 cos 45. And what is this vertical component value? That is V2 sin of 45. So in this way these components are getting resolved. Now we will move for here. So this is the force or the component of force for which the water is exerting force on the bend. But we want what is the force exerted by bend on water. So these forces are equal and opposite direction. So what is the force exerted by bend on the water? That is, it is in opposite direction. So we have to show magnitude is equal, but what is opposite? That is, direction is opposite. So here I will show that force will be minus Fx. And here we have to show this vertical component, that will be minus Fy. So that is the force exerted by bend on the waters, this minus Fx in direction of x, and minus Fy, that is the, we can say, component of force exerted by bend on the water in the direction of y, that is minus Fy. Now we will apply here momentum principle. So what is the momentum principle? That is the force acting on water which is equal to change in momentum, that is mass multiplied by change in velocity. So we will take here first the force acting on water along the direction of x. So we will write here net force acting on water in x direction is equal to rate of change of momentum in x direction. So what is this momentum? Momentum means mass multiplied by change in velocity. And now here we don't know what is the mass of water, but it is given that what is the rate of flow, that is Q is given. So we have to take mass per second, which is equal to Q into rho, rho that is density. So how we can write this? So now we will take here what is the net force acting on water. So first we will take this pressure force. So pressure force is P1A1. So we have to take along the direction of x. So if we observe this P1A1 is in horizontal direction, that is along the direction of x. So we will take here P1A1 x, because why we are taking here suffix x? Because this force component we are taking along the direction of x. Then we will take here P2A2, that is the pressure force at section 2. So along the direction of x we have to refer this component, that is P2A2 cos theta. So if we observe this P1A1 is having direction towards right hand side and this P2A2 is having direction towards left hand side. So we will give here the negative sign, so minus P2A2 cos theta x, because x is suffix that we have to consider here. And then this bend is also applying force along the direction of x, and that is equal to minus fx that I have shown. So we have to take minus fx, because this fx is also having direction towards the left hand side. So we will take minus fx. So these are the forces, or the net force acting on water, which is equal to, now on the right hand side we have to take mass per second multiplied by change in velocity. So what is the change in velocity? That is final velocity minus initial velocity along the direction of x that we have to consider. So what is mass per second? That is Q into rho. So we have to write rho into Q in the bracket final velocity along the direction of x. So here V2 cos 45 is the component of V2 along the direction of x. So its a direction is towards the right hand side. So we will take positive sign, that is V2x cos of theta minus we have to take V1. So V1 is also having the direction towards the right hand side. So only V1x. Now here suffix x is used because all these forces are along the direction of x. Now we will put the values. So it is easy for us because we have already calculated what is this P1, P2, A1, A2, V1, V2. So in we have already calculated, so we have to just put the values. So what is P1, A1? That is we have to apply here. So make the bracket, then minus P2, A2 cos theta. So P2, A2, then cos theta. Theta is 45 degrees. So cos of 45 minus fx, which is equal to rho into Q. So rho is 1000. What is Q? 0.6. In the bracket V2 cos theta. So what is V2? That is 8.488 into cos of 45 minus V1. That is 2.122. So we have to solve this. So only one unknown term, that is fx. So fx is equal to 19,911.4 newton. Now in the same way again we have to apply this momentum principle along the direction of y. That is net force acting on water in y direction is equal to rate of change of momentum in y direction. So what is the net force acting on direction of y? So we will first take this left hand side. So what about the pressure force? So pressure force along the y direction. So this is the horizontal component, or this horizontal force. So it's a vertical component is equal to 0. That is P1A1y will become 0. So we can write here P1A1y, that is 0. So just we have to write this P1A1y. Then we will take here P2A2 sin theta. Now this P2A2 sin theta, if we observe here, this is the direction is towards the downward direction. So for downward direction we will consider here negative sign. So minus P2A2y sin theta minus fy, because this bend is applying the force in the downward direction. So minus fy. minus Fy, which is equal to, on the right hand side we have to write mass per second, that is rho into q multiplied by final velocity minus initial velocity. So what is the final velocity? That is v2 sin 45. So v2y sin 45, so its direction is in the upward direction, so we will take positive sign, minus initial velocity. So its initial velocity, that is minus v1. So if we observe this v1 component, v1 is horizontal, so what is its vertical component? That is 0. So here we have to take 0, so I will write here we have to take 0, as well as this p1 a1 y, that is also 0. Now we will put here the value, that is p1 a1, so here p1 a1 y 0 minus p2 a2 y. So if we observe here p2 a2 sine of theta, so we will take here this value, or we will put here the value again, minus fy is equal to, now rho into q, that is 1000 into 0.6 in the bracket, now v2 sine theta, that is v2 sin 45. So we will take here the value 8.488 sin of 45 minus v1y. So here vertical component for this v1 is 0. So when we solve this, we will get fy is equal to minus 6322.2 newton. So here minus sign means the vertical component of force is in the downward direction. So we can also show here force which is in downward direction. And for this fx, here is positive sign. That means we can show this. This is fx is positive. That means this is direction is towards the right hand side direction. So this is the direction of fx. Now we will find out resultant force. So we know that resultant force Fr is equal to under root of Fx square plus Fy square. So when we put the value, we will get here resultant force 20,890.9 newton. Now we have to find out what is the position of this resultant force Fr. So if we plot here force Fx and force Fy, now here we know directions. So Fx is acting towards the right hand side because it is having positive sign, and here Fy is acting in the downward direction. So here we have to plot, this is the Fx and this vertically downward direction, this is the Fy, and here this is the resultant force Fr, and we have to find out this angle theta. So how to find out? So we have to make here one construction, that is draw a line, vertical line from this end point of this force Fx, and here horizontal line from the end point of this force Fy. So what is its this value for this vertical line? That is Fy. Now if we observe in this triangle, so I will give here letters A, B, C. So in this triangle A, B, C, here is the perpendicular angle. So we can write here what is the value of tan theta. So this tan theta is equal to this Fy divided by Fx, because this horizontal line is equal to magnitude of Fx and this vertical line is equal to magnitude of Fy. So for this Fy we have to write what is the magnitude of Fy, and for this Fx we have to write what is the magnitude of Fx. So tan theta is equal to 0.3175. So what is this angle theta? So theta is equal to 17 degree 36 minute. So this is the position of this resultant force from this horizontal line.